Welcome back.
So, Nazmul, what happened to your neck?
Oh, I hurt it. I actually have a slightly limited range of motion, and so I can only move this way, kind of like a robot.
Oh, no.
Like an alive android.
Sounds like you have a constraint.
I know. It is a constraint, but instead of fighting against it, I'm going to totally embrace it and work with it.
Well, actually, this lesson is all about how to work within constraints and deliver great user experiences. So, you're actually right at home.
I know. That's awesome. Let's get started. So in lesson two, we taught you some tools called personas and use cases that allow you to better prioritize your feature list and make really good applications. And you also learned a little bit about UX research.
And in lesson one, we taught you about low-res wireframing, which helps you think about the big picture first before you go into things like flows and details and UI elements. So Nazmul, let's talk about what you're going to learn in lesson three.
Okay.
In this lesson, you'll learn how to design for the mobile user, and how this is different from designing for a web or a desktop user. You'll also learn about four mobile constraints that you need to keep in mind for any mobile apps that you build. Then you'll learn more about wireframing, picking up from where we left off in lesson one. We're going to go deeper into how to design a flow of screens to support each step inside your application.